Hello and welcome to this Planet Zoo tutorial about using the Frontier Workshop for console. First of all, what is the workshop? This is essentially an online database for Planet Zoo console players to share and download player-created blueprints. So how do you access the workshop? From the main screen, if we navigate over here, simply click the option and you'll automatically be taken into the workshop. The homepage will show you the most popular creations uploaded this week, and you can navigate through these using the direction keypad left and right to browse. This includes every type of blueprint you can upload, so you'll get basic blueprints, habitat blueprints, and full zoos in here. The next tab, which you navigate to using L1 and R1, is browse. This refines your search for blueprints into separate categories. There's 5 categories, so shops and facilities, scenery, habitats, buildings, and full zoos. From here, to find a blueprint, you need to click into a category. To demonstrate, let's take a look at habitats. It will take a pause to load into the page, but once in, as you can see here, this is showing me all player blueprints uploaded that have been tagged as a habitat. Something that does bug me a little bit here, the blueprint tags are what players select manually when they upload, so not everything in here is what I class as a habitat. These uploads, for example, I'd consider this scenery and should just be tagged as a scenery, not habitat. Whereas something like this is clearly a habitat build. Hey ho, that is all player based, and if someone wants to add multiple tags, that's their prerogative, end of the day, isn't it? Anyway, moving on, you can narrow down your search here a little further. In the top right, you can see this is currently sorting blueprints by publication date, so that's starting with the most recently uploaded creations. Pressing the square button, you can change this to filter by ratings or total subscriptions. Rating will start with the most highly rated uploads, and total subscriptions will start with the blueprints that currently have the most players subscribed to it. If I change this to rating, this will now show me the most highly rated blueprints. And ooh, what do we have here? Shameless plug, spotted some of my own creations here in the first page, so yeah, let's take a look. Clicking on this blueprint, that will take me through to the blueprints page. This gives you a little more information about the blueprint, so a little description there, the tags information, and next is a tab that gives you some info about the creator of the blueprint. If I click on this, this gives you a few more options. Clicking the creations tab will take you to the creator's workpage shop, and this is where you can find everything that player has uploaded to the workshop. Within my page, you can easily see all 34 blueprints I've uploaded to the Frontier workshop to date. Pressing L2 and R2 will navigate between pages. Another way to filter blueprints is a keyword search. This is handy if you don't want to filter by tags, so where you don't mind if it's a habitat or a shop or whatever, but you have a keyword in mind. For this, I'll go into the All Creations tab. This is going to load every blueprint on the workshop in full. To search by keyword, I'll press triangle to open the search and tags function. At the top here, there's a box I can press triangle again to enter a keyword. This brings up the keyboard, which unfortunately you can't see this since it's a console command rather than an in-game prompt. But I'll keep this short and sweet, something that would be a typical search. Let's go with the word barn. There's bound to be a few it'll pick up with that. To perform the search for that word, press the circle button and it'll take me out of the filter tab and perform the search. And there we have it, it'll now show me everything in the workshop that includes the word barn in the title or description of the blueprint. From here, I can still filter this down like we did before, so instead of the publication date, I can change that to be rating and it'll change the order, showing me everything that's linked to the word barn, but starting with the most highly rated. So a really useful function there to nail down your search. That's everything I know about searching for blueprints, next I'll show you how to download them. Again, quite an easy task here. I'm back in my own creations here, and in the blueprint page. Oh, one more option before we subscribe. Below that button is the rate option. This is where you can rate creations, and basically that helps out the creators. If you take the time to give a thumbs up for that, that'll get the blueprint noticed more and ranked higher in the rated filter. So I'd recommend doing that for any blueprints you think deserve it. Well worth helping out those putting effort into making high quality blueprints for the workshop. Anyway, back to subscribing, click the subscribe button and it'll start downloading like so. There we go, now it says installed. That means it's downloaded this blueprint to my PS5 and will now show up in the blueprints tab in game. Let's take a look. Back in the game, navigate over to the blueprints tab and on the left hand side, navigate down to the Frontier workshop and that's where everything from the workshop will be stored. I don't have a lot in here, so at least it's easy to see this one I've just downloaded. Siberian Tiger Habitat, select this, it'll load up, and I can place that down in game. That's downloading blueprints, and it's the same for every blueprint aside from a full zoo. For full zoo blueprints, from the main page, go into My Zoos, and using L1 and R2 buttons, navigate over to the Downloads tab. This is where downloaded zoos will show up. I don't have anything in here because I never downloaded a zoo. But rest assured, any zoo you download will show up in this tab. That's everything about downloading, but what if you want to upload something you created yourself? That process, again, relatively easy, with a few variations depending on what you're uploading. I'll start off with a standard blueprint, which would be a set of pieces that all belong to one scenery group. Demonstrating quickly here, I've put down a couple of these African signs, and to upload this as a blueprint, I first need to blueprint the object so they're all connected as one group. To do this, I need to hold down X button to bring up the multi-select tool, then I can select each of these pieces in turn and they're being added to the selection. The tab on the top right, with all the pieces selected, I can navigate across here to the merge scenery into group option, and that places all three signs into a scenery group. With them grouped, I can now create a blueprint. That's the third option along, so save as a blueprint, and from here I'll select new blueprint and it takes me to the blueprint screen. There's some mandatory fields in here you have to fill in, and it's basically the game forcing you to categorise your blueprint, which will make it easier for other players to find in the workshop. So name a blueprint, let's just call this thing, and description. I'm only demonstrating how this works, so I'll just put TBC. It's useful to put something helpful in the description though to help others navigate and search for the blueprints easier in the game. Next is tags, and like I said before, I think it's pretty crucial to be honest with what the blueprint is rather than picking everything. You could of course pick all tags, but I don't think that's helping anyone navigate through thousands of blueprints on the workshop if there's things tagged with everything. For this demonstration, I'm going to select statues, as I guess that sounds most appropriate here. With the title, description, and tags, this is now ready to make into a blueprint. So I select create blueprint, and now it's a blueprint. To upload this to the Frontier Workshop, I need to go back into the Blueprints tab, find the blueprint, then press the square button for the options. And I can select Workshop Upload from here, which will take me to the Frontier Workshop upload page. Worth bearing in mind, on this page, the title and description, you have more characters here than you do in game, so if you want to slightly change the title or description from here, you can. Bearing in mind, that'll only change for the workshop description. Whatever you've put as the title, description, and tag in the game, when another player downloads your blueprint, that's what they'll see in-game regardless of what you change in here. Anyway, to upload, just click on the Upload to Frontier Workshop, and that'll upload the blueprint to the workshop under your profile. Obviously, this is just a demo, so not going to upload this myself. I'll move on to the next type of uploading you can do. Next, I'm back with the habitat build. To upload a habitat to the workshop, you want to navigate to and select the barrier gate. Right down at the bottom of the tab here, we've got the option to save as blueprint. Clicking that will take you back to the upload screen, and then it's the same process as everything else. If you want to upload an entire zoo to the workshop, from the main screen, you need to navigate into the My Zoos tab, select the zoo you want to upload, and simply navigate down to the Upload to Workshop option. Every time you select a blueprint or zoo to upload, it will automatically take you to the screen where you can either upload as new, or you can update an existing creation you've already uploaded. So there we go, that's everything I know about how the Frontier Workshop functions. If you do have any other questions about it, let me know in the comments. Hope this has been helpful. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you in the next video.